The work of having human values be reflected in AI is not strictly a technical challenge with a technical solution, but one that is indeed socio-technical. And with any socio-technical challenge, it has to be approached holistically, meaning you need to be thinking about people, process, tools. People meaning what is the right organizational culture that is required to curate AI responsibly, which are the right AI governance processes, and the right tools and AI engineering frameworks. When I take the time to ask large audiences at AI summits who in their organization is accountable for responsible outcomes from artificial intelligence, the top three answers that I get are pretty bad. The first answer I typically get is no one, which is overtly terrible. The second common response that I get is we don't use AI. Although you might not be keeping track of it in a formal inventory program, absolutely you have employees that are using artificial intelligence in some way, shape, or form. And then the last common response that I get is everyone. And I would opine that if everyone is being held accountable for responsible outcomes from AI, is anyone actually being held accountable? The job of those who are being held accountable for responsible outcomes from artificial intelligence is expanding. It's a big job, right? Not only do these people have to actually achieve value alignment within their organizations, they also have to keep track of AI model inventory. They have to keep track of regulations, right? And there are a growing amount of regulations around the world. But there's also a recognition that you can have AI models be lawful but awful, which means their purview, their responsibility actually has to push into ethics. And as soon as you push into ethics, you have to be a pretty darn good teacher. You have to be teaching those not only who are building AI models on your behalf and governing AI models on your behalf, but also who are going to be procuring AI models on your behalf. You want them to be able to do this work, and again, in a way that reflects your organization's values. First, I want to talk about what does AI literacy look like for those who are going to be governing AI models on your behalf. And the best way, my favorite way of approaching this kind of training is applied training. So the way that we work with those who are going to be governing AI models is, first of all, to dive into teaching people how do you operationalize principles like fairness, like explainability, like transparency. Thinking through how do you make sure you can detail what are those functional requirements for what you expect to see in AI models, but also the non-functional requirements of what you expect to see in those systems around those, the use of those AI models. Then the second group that you would offer this applied training to are those who will be building and buying models on your behalf. And this applied training includes things like making sure that you're choosing AI model use cases to actually work on, which ones are really important to your organization. And then diving into each of those use cases, starting with how do you make sure that the investment in that AI model is actually aligned to your business strategy? Teaching those teams working on those use cases, how do you assess for the risk of that particular use case, unintended effects of that use case? How would you approach mitigating those kinds of risks holistically? Then we give an introduction to fact sheets, in particular, not just how do you build a fact sheet, but how do you build one that's actually interpretable, that empowers people? We give an introduction to audits, and then we teach those teams how do you actually interpret the results from an audit so that they would know what to do when they see those audit results. Those doing this kind of applied training that I'm describing truly, truly benefit from actually working with a diverse and multidisciplinary team. Now, more than ever, having a leader or team that ensures the responsible use and responsible outcomes from artificial intelligence is absolutely crucial. Without a dedicated leader with a funded mandate to do this work, AI governance can absolutely fall through the cracks, leaving organizations vulnerable to the risks associated with the technology. A successful, responsible AI leader has a seat at the table and ensures that there are seats at the table for others including the CISO, ensuring the AI ethics is weaved into the very fabric of the organization, not just left off at the end, but incorporated across the entire AI life cycle. They make accountability policies transparent and work across the organization to see them implemented. Finally, championing AI literacy in a holistic way is absolutely essential, ensuring that everyone within the organization understands how to build and buy AI models that actually reflects the organization's values. By investing in a responsible AI leader with that funded mandate to do the work, organizations unlock the full potential of artificial intelligence. They drive innovation and they create a culture of responsible and transparent AI use, ultimately leading to better decision-making, improved customer experiences, and sustained business success.